So I'll start with a poem that I flip through, and it's always, I'm still with this same lady, Dana Falls. And I feel like the poem fits perfectly for what's going on right now. So it says, "Limitless, sun says, be your own illumination. Ren says, sing your heart out. All day long. Stream says, do not stop for any obstacle. Oak says, when the wind blows, bend easily and trust your roots to hold. Stars say, what you see in one small slice of single, what you see is one small slice of single modest galaxy. Remember the vastness cannot be grasped by mind. Ant says, small does not mean powerless. Silence says nothing. In the quiet, everything comes clear. I say limitless, I say yes." So there was some yoga event over the weekend that I was having a hard time. There was something about it that bothered me, and I didn't know what bothered me, and it was in a yoga event for Black Lives Matter. And I had a good cry. I kept thinking about it all day long. And then I texted my sister and I was like, tell me why this is bothering me. I can't figure it out. And I was like, I've been thinking about it all day long. And she goes, stop thinking and start feeling. And after that is kind of what helped me figure out what was bothering me about it. And so I say it a lot, I think, reflecting on your thoughts and how it affects you, and now with a different focus, like reflecting on how it feels in your body and trying to see what message it's sending to you, I think is one of the most important things. And to stop, because we can get caught up in all different things that we are, I feel like, are getting bombarded. And I also deleted Instagram and Facebook from my phone to kind of bring it back to me instead of what everyone else is saying. So like, I think the poem has a good message, but I also feel like that's how I feel right now. Like, the sun's telling me one thing, the bird's telling me one thing, everybody's telling me one thing, and I need to come back to what's me and what's important to me. And if we could all do that and do that from a loving place, I think we would be in a much better place. So, with love, I guess we can do a little yoga to help our bodies stretch out and connect us more with our body, because I think that's one of the most important things that help us move through some emotions. So we're going to start in a seated, easy seated pose. Over here. And if you place your hands on your shin, we're going to do a cat-cow a little bit differently. So instead of cat-cow on all fours, we're going to do it seated. So you're going to use your shins for support to kind of pull your chest forward. And then curl your back. So inhale, shine your heart through. Exhale, curl. Inhale, shine your heart through. Exhale, curl your back. Inhale, exhale. And cat-cows actually help to open up your heart space. So
So you could feel into your emotions.
Inhale.
Exhale.
Inhale.
Exhale. I'll let you do a couple on your own.
And next one, come back to a neutral spine and place your hand, your left hand on your knee and gently, sorry, let me back up. So bring your right ear to your right shoulder, place your left hand on your knee and your right hand like right above your left ear to kind of help it, like don't push it so you're straining, but just to help the stretch of your neck. And try to feel the on your left side. And we'll hold it for 3 breaths. Back to center, place your right hand on your right knee, bring your left ear to your left shoulder so you can feel the stretch. On the right side, bring your hand above your ear to help the stretch. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. And we'll hold it for 3 more breaths on this side. Next inhale, come back to center, roll the shoulders back, inhale, bring them up, exhale, roll them down, inhale, bring them up to your ears, exhale, bring them down, inhale, exhale, and I'm going to give you, if you do that again, 3 more times on your own. Neutral, place your left hand on your right knee and your right hand behind you. Inhale for length, exhale, twist. And I like to keep my nose in line with my chest, but if it's comfortable on your neck, you can gently look back. So inhale for length, exhale, twist. Inhale, slowly come back to center. Inhale for length. Exhale, twist. Place your right hand on your left knee. Inhale for length, twist. Try to imagine like a long string from your sit bones all the way up to your spine.
Next inhale, come back to center. And slowly come back onto your backs. And this is where you're going to need your towel. Inhale, bring your right knee to your chest. Kind of roll around with it a little bit. Now go the opposite way. Now you can grab your towel and you can place it kind of like on the sole of your foot. Hold it here for a couple of breaths. And then we're going to slowly open up. You can place your left hand on your left hip. And you're going to slowly open up. And as soon as you start feeling that left hip come up, then that means you've reached your edge. So then back up a tiny bit. Flex your left toes. Keep the left leg engaged. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, now you're going to grab the towel with your left hand and ground your right hand on the floor. And then you're going to bring your leg towards your left. And right where you feel that stretch, then you can stop there. Make sure you're listening to your body. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, bring your right leg down. Bring your right knee up to your chest. And you can roll it around. Exhale. Inhale, bring it opposite side. Now grab your towel again and put it around the sole of your foot. Bring your, my knee just cracked. Bring your leg towards the sky. You can flex both your left toes and your right toes. And you should feel the stretch on the back of your leg. Again, you can place your hand on your right hip. You can start opening your leg up. And as soon as your hip starts to come up, then come back. Down a little bit. Back up a little bit. Flex your right toes. Flex your left toes. Make sure you're breathing. Inhale, come to center. Switch your hands. Exhale, bring your foot towards the right, and both of your sides are very different, or can be different, and you should feel the stretch on the side of your leg, your T-band. center. Let go of your legs. Kind of wiggle them a little bit, release all that. Bring your feet to the ground so that your knees are pointed to the sky. And if it's available, you could bring your heels so that it's grazing the tips of your fingers. Bring your hands behind you. And as you lift your hips, you're going to push your hands down. So, kind of like going in opposite directions, oppositions. So, inhale. Exhale, lower your hips, bring your hands behind you. Inhale, lift and push your hands towards your mat. Exhale, lower. Flowing bridge. Inhale, lift and push your hands slowly. I'll let you flow a little bit on your own. You can do three on your own. That's the magic number for today. And we'll do one more and we'll hold it there with our hips high. Make sure that you're pressing on all four corners of your feet. And don't let your knees sway out or in. Try to have them pointing in alignment with your hips. Exhale, lower. Inhale, bring your knees to your chest, roll around a little bit. Roll the opposite side, massaging your lower back. And slowly, into all fours for a tabletop.
Can you see me? Am I still on? Okay.
Fours, make sure you're pressing down with all 10 fingers, that your shoulders are over your wrist, your hips are over your knees. And we're going to do a figure eight with our bodies. So move your body towards your left hand and towards your right hand, come down and around. So we're making a figure eight with our bodies. Try to feel into your body. Now we can go the opposite way. Inhale, exhale. Next time, come back to neutral. Bring your toes together. Pull your knees apart. And let your hips fall for child's pose. You can stretch your arms out. And bring your forehead to the mat. Inhale, tend your fingers like a little spider. Lift your neck a little bit, and you're going to crawl your hands to your right side. And then lower your forehead again. You can either leave your fingers tended, or you can place them down. You should feel a stretch on the left side of your body. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, move to the left side of your body. And now you should feel a stretch on your right side. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, come to all fours. Inhale, tuck your toes. Use your knees for support. Bring your hips up to the sky for downward dog. You can pedal out your legs. You can shake your head no, shake your head yes. Make sure that you're pressing on all 10 fingertips. Now we can come back to stillness. That brings us back to what we are truly inside, not what everybody else is telling us to be. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, bend your knees and walk to the top of your mat. Ragdoll. You can bring your legs wider apart. You could hold on to your elbows and let your head be heavy. Again, you can shake yes, you can shake no, you can shake yes. You can swing your body back and forth. You can move your weight a little bit towards your toes, a little bit towards your heels, and then try to bring your weight evenly on your feet. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Press on your feet. Root to rise, bring your hands above your head, bring your prayer through. part, remember, if you put both of your hands together and you place it in between your feet, and that's how you know that you're at hips width distance. And open up for mountain pose. You can bring your shoulders back up to your ears and let them fall behind. Engage your quads, open up. Connect with yourself, connect with your heart. Inhale, extend your arms up above. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Bring your shoulders back, go straight back. Exhale, plant your hands. Place one knee behind you, then your other knee. Move past your wrists. Lower your chest, lower your chin. Roll your hips forward for cobra. Exhale, you can use your knees for support to bring it back to downward dog. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, walk or step to the top of your mat. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, root to rise with slight bent knees. Bring your prayer through. Inhale, bring your hands up above you. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift with a straight back. Exhale, plant your hands, come to all fours. Move a little bit past your wrist, lower your chest, lower your chin. Roll your hips forward for cobra. Exhale, downward dog. We could do one more sun salutation. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, walk or step to the top of your mat. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale with slight bent knees. Come up to standing. Inhale, bring your hands up above you. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your hands on the ground. Come to all fours, move past your wrists, lower your chest, lower your chin, roll your hips forward for cobra, exhale, downward dog. Make sure you're connecting with your breath. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, come to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Spread your feet so that they're as wide as your mat. Come this way. And you can lower your bottom for Malasana or squat, and this is a good pose to ground you and bring you back to yourself. Don't let your hips just fall to the ground. Use strength push your elbows to your knees and your knees to your elbows. Inhale, place your hands on the ground. Exhale, come back to forward fold. Bring your feet back to hips width distance. This way. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, place your hands on the ground and use your come to all fours and use your knees for support to go to downward dog. Inhale, lift your right leg. Exhale, slowly with control, you're going to bring it to tap close to your right arm. Inhale, come back to three-legged dog. Exhale, tap your knee to your left elbow. Come back to three-legged dog. Inhale, bring your knee to the middle. Place your foot in between your hands. Pivot on your left foot, and you can place a hand on your knee and come up for warrior two. And today I want to spend a little bit more time on warrior two. So in warrior two, it's important to have things, when all the poses, it's important to have your body in alignment so that your hip, your shoulders, are over your hips. So try to take some time to kind of move your body side to side and find a neutral place. Bend your knee and look down to see if you can see your big toe. If you can't see your big toe, then move your knee so that it's also in alignment with your toes. Your knee should be above your foot, and you should be pressing on the left side of your leg and engaging your left glute. And extend your arms, bring them down. You could straighten now the right leg. You can reach and come down with an open heart for triangle pose. You can leave your hand on your waist. And if your shoulders are one above the other, you could try it. You can extend your arm up above you. You can look to your toes. You can look straight ahead. You can look up. Whatever's best for your neck. Inhale, come back with control for warrior two. Exhale, pivot on your left foot. Turn your body around slowly for high lunge. Engage your left quad and your left glute. Exhale, bring your hands to the ground. Come back for plank. Lower your knees. Bring your toes together and you could let your hips fall for child's pose. We'll stay here for three breaths because that's the magic number today. If you're ready, you can come back to all fours. Press on your 10 fingertips. You can use your knees for for support. Bring your hips up to the sky for downward dog. Inhale, lift your left leg. Exhale, tap your left elbow. Re-extend your leg. Inhale, tap your right elbow. Re-extend your leg. Inhale, place your left foot in between your hands. And open up for warrior two. I think that's what we did before. Turn around. So again, bring your shoulders over your hips. Try to have a 9-degree bend on your left leg. Make sure you can see your toe, that you're pressing on your left knee so that you're just not here, that you're using your body's strength. Inhale, straighten your left leg. Exhale, kind of tick-tock your arms. Bring your one shoulder over the other. You can place your hand on your hip, or you can extend your arm up above. Again, look to see what's right for your neck. Engage your abs. Inhale, come back to warrior two. Exhale, pivot on your right foot for high lunge. Exhale, place your hands, bring your hands to the ground. Bring your left foot back for plank. Lower your knees. Do another child's pose, or you can move through your vinyasa. Inhale. Lift your heels. Exhale, come to the top of your mat. Bring your feet as wide as your mat for another yogi squat or malasana. So don't just have a straight back. Push your elbows into your knees into an elbows. Connect with your breath. Inhale, bring your right hand to the ground. You could stay here, or you could bring your right hand to the ground and open up with your left hand. Exhale, come back to center. Bring your left hand to the ground. Open up with your right hand. Inhale, come back to center. We'll do it one more on each side. Center. Inhale, place your hands on the ground. Bring your feet back to hips width distance. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold and fold. Root to rise. heel, as a kickstand, below your knee, above your knee. And you can stay here, or you can extend your arms out. You can cactus your arms. You're trying to bring your shoulders back. Trying to point your knee out. Push your foot into your thigh and your thigh into your foot. Sometimes when you're feeling unbalanced, finding a little more stretch, strength, brings you back that balance that you need. Inhale, come back center, and wiggle it all out. Now try grounding your right foot and your left toe. You can either have a kickstand below your knee or above your knee. Press down on your right foot. You can find something to focus on, a little spot somewhere. You could stay here. Bring your hands up above you. Cactus your arms. I feel like with all the tension I have on my shoulders, when I cactus my arms, that helps to stretch them out a little bit. If you need more of a challenge, you can look up and you can pull up. And just like that, and you get back up. That this is what I think whenever I fall. I'm human. Now I'm super wobbly. Again, I'm human. If we fall, what do we have to learn from that? Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, shake it out. You can either have your feet hips width distance, or you can bring them together. Try it first, hips width distance. Bring your hands up above you. With your right hand, hold on to your left wrist. Grounding your feet to the ground. Extend and move to the right side. You should feel the stretch in your left side of your body. Bring your navel to your spine, engage your abs. Again, we're trying to open up our heart here too. Inhale, come to center. Exhale, bring your left hand to your right wrist. Inhale for length. Exhale. Fall to the side, extend to the side, try to open up your heart. Come back to center. We can try it with our feet together. Inhale for length. Exhale, hold on to your left wrist, twist to the side. Inhale, center. Exhale, switch your grip, go to the opposite side. Inhale, come to center. and try to think about which one felt better for your body, either feet together or hips width distance apart. And you can make that choice for yourself. We'll do it one more time. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, come to center. Exhale, go to the opposite side. Inhale, come to center. And revisit mountain pose. Hips width distance, your feet are hips width distance apart. Ground up to all four corners of your feet. You can actually lift your toes. And then slowly lower your toes, engaging your quads, your abs. Bring your shoulders to your ears. Bring your shoulders back down. Open up for mountain pose. Think about maybe one more way that you can start listening to your own heart, connecting with your own heart. Together. You can place your hands on the soles of your feet, kind of open them up like a book, and try to see what's more comfortable in your body. Is it more comfortable to come closer, a little bit further away? Inhale, lengthen your back. Exhale, fold. And right when you find your edge, you can let your head drop. Inhale, come to center. Exhale, you can bring your feet out a little bit more so now that it looks more like a diamond. And if it's available on your body, you can bring your hands underneath your legs and around your feet. Inhale for length. Exhale, fold. Just like before, once you find your edge, you let your head fall. And you should feel this on a different side of your hips. Next time you inhale, come back up. Now this time you can extend your legs out. You can place your hands behind you for length. Flex your feet. This might be enough for you. If you need a little bit more, you can come bring your feet in front of your hands in front of you, and you can crawl them up slowly until you feel a good stretch. Inhale for length, exhale fold. And it doesn't matter how low you go, as long as you're honoring your body. The nice thing about doing yoga in your own house is that you don't compare yourself to anybody else. Because when we compare ourselves to other people, we're just hurting ourselves. And I still haven't learned that lesson. I'm learning it. I'm practicing that lesson. Inhale, crawl your fingers back. Exhale, use your hands for support. Bring them underneath your knees to bring your feet back together. You can extend your legs, or actually you can keep them bent. Place your hands behind your thighs and slowly come back onto your back. Okay, do one more. Put your figure four, bring your right foot, your right ankle on your left knee. Flex your right toes. You can stay here if you want a little bit more sensation. You can thread your hand behind your right, your left thigh. If you need a little bit more sensation, you can bring it closer to you. You can use your right elbow to push onto your thigh. Breath. And you should feel the stretch on the outside of your hips. Come back to center. Switch out your legs. Bring your left ankle to your right knee, flex your left toes. You could stay here. You could thread your hands behind your right knee, your right leg. If you want a little bit more sensation, you can bring it closer to your body. You can push with your left elbow. And your hips is where you store all your emotions. Feet back to the ground. Lift your hips and move them a little bit towards the right. And bring your knees up and let them fall to the left. You can extend your arms out in a T. And if it's comfortable on your neck, you can look to the opposite side. Exhale through your mouth, sigh it out, twist circuit for detoxifying your body. see what feels better on your back, you can bring your knees closer to you, farther away from you. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, bring your feet to the ground. Lift your hips and scoot them over to the left side. Lift your knees and let your knees fall to the right. Bring your arms out back to a T. You can see what feels good on your back, either bringing your knees lower or higher. Also look at what feels nice on your neck. Side out again. Bring your neck back to center. Bring your knees back to center. Hug your knees into a little ball. Let's squeeze into a tight little ball. Scrunch your face up, squeeze it all in. Exhale, let it off go. And you made it to Shavasana. So you can bring your feet out. I have to bring them out as wide as my mat. Let your hands fall. You can come back to a normal breath. Your breath. And if your mind wanders, that's okay. Just bring your mind back. And if you need a little bit of help focusing your mind, you can bring your hands to your stomach and your heart and become more aware of your breath. Start to waken up your body, wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Open up and close your mouth, stretch out your jaw. Do a big yawn, big morning stretch. Bring your knees towards you. And roll onto either your left or the right side.
fetal position. You can use your opposite hand for support to bring you back to seated.
That today's practice helped you to get connected a little bit more with your own heart, with your own body. The light in me sees the light in each and every one of you.